The first good news was that we actually saw tumor shrinkage in almost every tumor that we, every patient that we enrolled. And this shrinkage was not dramatic and large in most patients, but it was measurable. And this is something we had never seen before. And what is important here is that we treat young patients, and most of these patients have tumors that are growing. And so even if we see shrinkage that is minor, what that implies is that we don't see growth. And in my mind, stopping a tumor from growing in and of itself could be benefit because we prevent complications that may happen. Our phase one clinical trial of the MEK inhibitor, what had the primary goal to really identify what is the maximum tolerated dose that we can give to these children who will have to take this drug for a long period of time. What are the side effects that we see? And in addition, how does the patient handle the drug? We call this pharmacokinetics, where we look at the plasma concentrations over time. In addition, as a secondary objective, we also wanted to look at what does the drug do to the tumors of these patients. Patients with NF1 have sometimes very large, disfiguring, painful tumors called plexiform neurofibromas, and we measure these tumors with a method using volumetric MRI analysis. Of importance is, in many clinical trials that I've done in the past, we have not seen shrinkage of the tumors, and we have not seen that the medicines that we tested would delay the time to progression. So overall, most of these studies were negative. And my expectation going into this phase one trial with a MEK inhibitor was, of course, we always hopeful that something else might happen, but we didn't really, to be perfectly honest, expect it. We have studied these tumors at the NCI for a long period of time. We've developed criteria how to measure these tumors. We can sensitively measure changes over time, and we were able to implement meaningful clinical trial designs. This all kind of led up to us being able to really understand what is going on when we give new agents, and shows a prime example why the NCI is doing these studies. I do feel we have made substantial contributions here that would be really difficult to do outside of the NCI intramural program.